There's a few thunderstorms on the way tonight. Tomorrow, those thunderstorm chances go down just a bit in the upstate and the temperatures go up. Yikes, a hot one. Low to mid 90s tomorrow. Be by a pool or by a lake. That's going to be the spot to be tomorrow. And as we move forward here, I'm mapping out a few thunderstorm chances, which will get some of us the chance to see some rain. But the temperatures, that's the big story going into next week. We should normally be at 89. We're within a couple of degrees of that Saturday and Sunday, but then going below normal going into the middle part of next week. Let me show you storm chances. 8, 9, 10 o'clock tonight. We certainly could still have some storms firing up across the area. The mountains trying to break up a lot of this activity, but some briefly heavy rainfall will certainly be likely across a good bit of the area here. Then that passes to the south and we'll have better weather move our way. As we go into Saturday, most of us are staying dry all day. Can't rule out a pop-up storm here or there across Greenville, Spartanburg, or Anderson tomorrow, but the majority of us will begin to dry out. Still going to be hot though Saturday. The last of the fronts move through on Sunday, and that's going to usher in better weather for us. That north and northwesterly wind's going to be in place all of next week, bringing temperatures down. In fact, the new outlook for the East Coast from the Georgia to the Carolinas up through New York shows below normal temperatures expected through Monday, August 22nd. It's not going to be cool out, but comfortable, sure. Hurricane Ernesto, it's a Category 2 hurricane bearing down on Bermuda right here. A couple of hundred miles away from the United States, but rip current is still a problem as we go through Saturday, especially in the Carolina coast. Now, moving forward here as we track the tropics, brand new track out on this shows it will begin to steadily weaken, entering some wind shear and some cooler waters here. But this system is going to continue to kind of plow its way, scraping by Canada and then continuing across the Atlantic as a pretty potent low pressure system with winds remaining around 45 miles per hour. As we look deeper into the future, there goes Ernesto. Some energy rolls off the coast of Africa next week. A lot of it kind of fizzles out after it splashes down in the Atlantic with not much consequence. Could have a tropical depression here or there, but a lot of these kind of turn north early on around this big Bermuda high. What we'll watch for next week, this will be a week from right now, is a couple of strong waves splashing down near the Cape Verde Islands. Those would need to be watched. But again, I'm telling you, this is next Saturday, so about a week away. And then at that time frame, if it were to come toward the United States, it'd still be 12 to 14 days from becoming any kind of threat. So we've got a couple of weeks here to watch closely for as we get toward the peak of hurricane season. So the 4-day looks like this. A 30% chance of storms tomorrow, 93. Remaining hot on Sunday before we start to actually cool down. Check out these temperatures next week. Highs in the low 80s, that's about 5 to 10 degrees below normal, and lows at night in the low 60s, feeling really quite comfortable. In the mountains, even better. We've got a stretch of 50s locked in the morning hours, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, with highs only in the 70s.